Memory, which is that constitution of the universe, which through this coming and going and circular motion in physiology and in awareness allow us to appreciate the totality of the birthright of a human being. And in the brain, the same thing. We can think of the front of the brain and the back of the brain. The back of the brain has circular activity. The front of the brain also has its dynamics of circular mechanics. There are layers upon layers where the front and the back then work with each other and with many other areas of the brain. And so another great circle upon circle upon circle. This is the mechanics of brain functioning, in which loops upon loops of back and forth motion structure brain coherence and therefore the highest levels of human experience. In this picture of the brain, the yellow part is the front, which is the CEO, or more related to self-referral functioning, and the back of the brain, shown in green here, is more of where the world is constructed. So the front and its dynamics gives us some reflection of that CEO or sense of self, and that can be seen in the brain waves as fluctuations of electroactivity, and the back can also be measured, and that's where we construct our reality of the world. And in that back and forth motion of brain activity, we also create brain waves. The question is the CEO creating proper looping, and is the world creating proper looping, and does the EEG reflect that, and can we measure it? And indeed, when a person begins the practice of transcendental meditation, the CEO and the world are showing by two different EEG tracings. Within a short period of time, upon closing the eyes and beginning the practice of meditation, one can shift to a remarkable change. This remarkable change from the left to the right is seen during the practice of Maharshi's Transcendental Meditation Program. And in this, we see three main phenomena, which is the essence of the unification of that silent value of nature's functioning. The first is that we see that there's a simplification, that diversity becomes greatly unified, and the whole dynamics of circular activity of the brain collapses to a very simple unified value of alpha. We also see that each part of the brain becomes very orderly, and we refer to this as local coherence, that each part becomes very orderly on its own. And then finally, as each part becomes orderly, they come together and coalesce like drops of water coalescing to create an ocean of consciousness. This is unity and diversity. This is that grand unity and diversity. Here is a picture describing this in more detail of cortical cell looping activity. The image on the left is a very simple picture of a couple of brain cells of the human cortex. Although this may be quite large on your TV screen, this white box is only the thickness of a coin, a few millimeters thick. However, there's a considerable amount of dynamic activity in there because as these cells function, they create loops of electrical fluctuation, a back and forth circular motion. This occurs in vast numbers. And what happens is that as these cells fluctuate in their activity, innumerable levels of fluctuating activity, we give rise to the EEG. And we're going to describe that in the next slide. Here is an area of the cortex on the left-hand side, and there are three different color loops which indicate that the different cells are doing different activity. There's a sort of a fragmentation or a diversification of cortical activity, giving rise to three styles of brain activity by these different color loops. Now, that gives rise to usually a very shallow and very thin level of brain waves seen in this stripple above them, that little black line, because most activity cancels each other out because of the vast diversity. It doesn't amount to much. But if we take that same area, called Area 1, for example, and we look at that same area, but now allow it to coalesce, allow it to become more integrated, so all the cells start sharing that same alignment. In that case, what happens is that there's a profound transformation, not only in awareness, but through that brain functioning, we can see in a level the change in brain coherence. This is referred to as local coherence. Between the right, left and the right, we can see on the right-hand side a larger, more simplified, more powerfully orderly structure of brain dynamics corresponding to much more expanded value of self or Atma. Now, there's one other value of coherence besides local coherence, which we see here. Local coherence, again, being that when one area of the brain changes its style of function, it becomes more integrated, more orderly. That's local coherence. But there's something more to the human brain, its ability to be globally coherent. And in this example, we have two parts of the cortex, an area 1 on the left and area 2 on the right. You could say that the area 1 is the front of the brain related to the CEO or the self, and the area in the back is related more to the world. The question is, are these areas collected together and integrated to a vast, grand wholeness? So let's example that. We could take the area one, let's say the front of the brain, and if that area is working together in a synchronous, coherent manner, you would imagine it would be very, very orderly and give rise to local coherence. In the back of the brain, area two, if it also happened to be working in an orderly, synchronous fashion, it would be more integrated. And that vast integration would also be registered as local coherence. So the front would be locally coherent and the back would be locally coherent. But what if these two areas were able to communicate with each other through different mechanisms known to modern science and described by His Majesty Maharaja Nataramji in his beautiful book, In Discovery? What if they could work together and communicate? We could then create a vast ocean of orderly, unified activity, and this is referred to as global coherence. So we have local coherence, and we have global coherence. And so for that, I want to give you an example, again, of how that happens in human brain physiology. So I'll take a moment here, and I'm going to go to our brains, and we're going to go to and here we go. Let me see what we got here. Play stop. All right. Okay, that didn't take long. Here we go. Now we're going to, if we can come back to the screen, we're going to show you a screen of coherence now. Maximum coherence at the top and minimal coherence at the bottom. This is frontal alpha coherence, the closest indication of the sense of self, which we'll get to later in the lecture. And you can see the profound change that occurs in the individual. You can see that on the left-hand side of the screen, the individual had their eyes closed but not meditating. And then right under the word alpha, they started to meditate. And you can see that the EEG transformed tremendously and remained in a very high level of coherent activity. This is an example, again, of how we have local and global brain coherence. This graph shows how the front of the brain on the left and right-hand sides becomes greatly integrated. And then we'll, if we can, we'll come back to our screen here, and we can return now to this slide. So what we've seen in this short idea of the looping with local and global coherence is that with local and global coherence, we see the growth of enlightenment, the growth of alignment of the individual with the cosmic. We see in published research that this coherence during transcendental meditation can be maintained in waking state. In fact, it can be maintained over the 24 hours. Published research shows that brainwave coherence is the best measure of the development of higher states of consciousness, enlightenment, cosmic consciousness, and that local coherence is seen as very high amplitudes of alpha and theta, and global coherence is seen as broadband coherence in the front of the brain. So here we have this idea of local and global, individual and the wholeness, the part and infinity, the individual, and the cosmic. This is indication that coherence as measured in brainwave activity is a beautiful measure of all good things. All good things are shown to be related to brainwave coherence. And the best thing about the brain is its ability to us to access and make use of that constitution of the universe, the gift of Gurudev. Now the second part of this presentation is also about loops, but we want to talk about now the different types of loops in terms of frequencies. The first part of the loops was